Often veiled in obscuring mist from the foggy moss, the distillery has long been shrouded in mystery, and why the dram of locals and bucky fishermen has been a secret savored for over 100 winters. It's a secret to us. Welcome to the We Dram, and tonight, the Altmore 12. So a beautiful honeyed color, the Altmore coming from the Speyside region, and generally used to create a great deal of Dewar's whiskey. At one point they said 70 years straight production, and then in the last little while, they decided that it was time to have their own single malt and not simply be a mule for Dewar's. Top notch, exciting, beautiful evening. A beautiful whiskey and an opportunity to open another one here at the We Dram. Awesome. All right, so you see this evening a little bit differently. We've already brought it out because we want to enjoy the way the whiskey looks in the beautiful evening light, but the cylinder is worth mentioning. They do a nice, simple, but interesting graphic on the front with the distillery hidden behind what looks like an ocean. Of course, we learned that Altmore is nowhere near an ocean, so a little bit interesting. It could be a river, but even apparently Altmore is about 3 miles away from a river and the water source. I'm not sure how they actually get it there. So a little bit of confusion on the graphic, but nonetheless, it's interesting. Some little flying dove, it looks like, maybe holding a peace branch, who knows. Also, the Altmore distillery established in the 19th century, so 1897. Look at this, we've got a seal, a serious seal, which could pose a challenge actually. What the heck, this is Fort Knox here. Could use some sort of a blade. Teeth, ready for the cork, Johnny? Always a good time, and that was a nice cork. Really good cork. Sweet honey off the nose right away in the outdoor July weather here in British Columbia. We're about to pour the Altmore 12. Again, notably light colored whiskey. Earlier in the bottle, I said it looked like honey, but now that it's in the glass, it looks lighter than that. And as it sits in the natural light of the evening, noting that the viscosity of this whiskey might be something to consider. Take it to the nose. Notes of cream, honey, with an overarching vanilla and hint of haystack cereal, dried porridge, something in the kitchen. The more I smell it, the more lovely I believe it is. It's delightful. So long, Cheval. Altmore 12, let's see what you're gonna bring to the palate. Wow, a lot going on there. Most of it very good. It had several moments, which is an indicator of complexity, that the story doesn't begin quickly and end quickly. It stays with you for some time. The flavor starts off incredibly mild, draws you in, and then has a moment, a smoky moment almost, and then a whoosh. It just disappears and then has a lingering aftertaste. It has really some nice movements here. Second sip, almost like reminds me of an Isle of Arran chocolate up on the front. And then as it dissipates and leaves you and then all of a sudden rushes back with a not quite spicy, more towards smoke with a touch of pepper in it, but nothing like close to anything of note. You know, it has its own thing going on entirely. And then the aftertaste on the second one wasn't as potent. It was certainly less intense and less pronounced. So the palate is adjusting. A third to tie it all together. A really interesting flavor up front. Chocolatey bread, almost a mahogany, like a something wood and high. And it all sets you up nicely and then just zoom, down she goes. Disappearing and then re-arriving, you know, having a final reveal on a very nice finish. Excellent, excellent whiskey. Oh, I can draw some comparisons right now. I mean, it almost has a Dalwhinnie 15 going on there. It has some of that feel to it. My hat's off to you, Oldmoor 12. Thank you for considering the single malt crowd, because I definitely think this is a worthwhile expression at 46% natural color, unchilled filtered. Not 100% sure what the cost would be, because this was a duty free that came from overseas, and it's very difficult to identify where this would sit in the market. So in terms of coming up with some sort of a rating, without the knowledge of what it's actually worth in dollars and cents, boy, I think it rates 3 and above. It could easily be a 4. So thank you for joining us. Thank you for being here in this beautiful evening, drinking this beautiful whiskey. If you get a chance to try the Oldmoor 12, the wee dram certainly recommends. Salon Shiva, enjoy your week, enjoy your drams. If this was cheaper than a Dalwhinnie 15, we're buying this all the time, you know.